Hello there, everyone. It's Tanya Gabrielle, wealth astrologist. Welcome to Star Codes. This is the podcast where we look at the current or upcoming astrology numerology events. And today is going to be a celebration of Jupiter in Pisces, joy entering spirituality. This is such a loving moment where the largest planet of our solar system, Jupiter, moves into a new part of the zodiac, and we're feeling the ripple effects of this change in depth. The enhancing of everything is very pronounced. And so let's start with the fact that Jupiter entered Aquarius, the sign that precedes Pisces, in December. And if you remember, it entered Aquarius along with Saturn. They were conjunct on the solstice on the 21st of December at 0 degrees Aquarius. And since that time, Jupiter has raced through Aquarius and now has entered Pisces. So we've been moving into the Aquarian era since Jupiter and Saturn both entered last December. And now that Jupiter has moved through Aquarius, the last few months have really sparked this sense of freedom, innovation, breakthroughs that help us connect the dots in new, exciting ways, and also help us to create a deeper sense of community. And Jupiter's sojourn in Aquarius is going to continue, as you'll see in a moment. But right now, Jupiter just entered Pisces, and we'll be there until July 28th, so for about 2.5 months. So it'll be a brief visit, but it indicates the more general themes that will be in play once Jupiter re-enters Pisces on December 30th this year and throughout 2022. So the next 2.5 months are going to attract a lot of opportunities. And the thing that's so lovely about Jupiter in Pisces is that Jupiter was actually the classical ruler of Pisces before Neptune was discovered and assigned to Pisces. So Neptune is the modern ruler, but Jupiter was and still is considered a very big part of the Piscean experience. Jupiter is the planet of expansion and fortune and wisdom and justice and truth. And Pisces is mystical, dreamy, spiritual, filled with unconditional love. And also the last sign, it governs endings as well. So Jupiter in Pisces can indicate dreams, coming to the forefront, coming out of the unconscious, and then eventually coming true. So there's a lot of rapid personal inner spiritual growth that is happening when Jupiter enters this sign. And the more creative and joyful you are as you approach your day-to-day activities, the greater the positive outcomes. Now, as we reach the second month or the second part of May, there's also a full moon eclipse that's coming up in conjunction with Mercury stationing retrograde in its own sign of Gemini. So the pressure is building now, and whatever is happening in your life, it's being enhanced. You can actually get more done, make more aha moments, thrive, and get in touch, of course, with your heart, with love. And it's a really powerful total eclipse that's coming up. It's in Sagittarius. The moon is opposite the sun in Gemini. And as I said, Mercury is at this point slowing down in Gemini where the sun is. And the north and south nodes are in those signs as well. So this is really going to be a big moment, and it's building now. Plus the eclipse, speaking of Jupiter in Pisces, the eclipse is square to Jupiter in Pisces, and that will enlarge and magnify the energy. The square does that anyway, because the square is a call to action. And of course, Pisces is the water sign of unconditional love. It reaches everywhere. We are all one. And Jupiter is the planet of expansion, so everything will be enhanced. And so you want to keep a sense of calm and proportion in any situation, especially when you are with others, and give them the benefit of the doubt, especially since this eclipse is happening during the beginning of a Mercury retrograde. So what would be good to do now is to finish things up, to clean things up that need completion, forgive others, let them off the hook. If you feel a little bit scattered, this Jupiter in Pisces energy is creating a sense of unpredictability as well, because water just goes everywhere, and the expansiveness is also a sense of change, of movement. The waves of shifts and changes are really flowing right now. Jupiter in Pisces is highly spiritual energy, and so we're very likely going to feel even more tuned in and connected and in touch with our intuitive sense, our soul, our heart. And because Jupiter represents abundance as well, and Pisces rules over things like spirituality and religion, and they're very similar. As I said, Jupiter was the original ruler of Pisces, so there's a sense of being at one with source energy, with God. And so there's a lot of opportunities to reach deeper levels of awareness. And of course, being the last sign of the zodiac, Pisces is also about completing things and understanding the whole of what just transpired, right, through all the 12 signs, coming to a place of transcendental wisdom. So with Jupiter expanding the vision, we can unlock a deeper appreciation of our journey and see the bigger picture. And it's also very dreamy energy being in Pisces, so that your creativity, your inner creator, is yearning to explore. So use your imagination in any way you can. This can be a great opportunity to work on creative projects or projects that deal with alternate realities or mysticism, astrology, numerology. And there's also a sense of you just have this inner knowing. Your intuition just provides everything that you need. You don't have to use your mind to analyze so much right now. You know, Jupiter's moved out of the sign that can be very analytical, Aquarius, the air sign, and into a water sign. So this is really about sensing and trusting what you're receiving. And overall, this Jupiter in Pisces energy really blesses us with this beautiful energy that helps strengthen our connection to source and our relationship with others. The whole sense of when we are with others, we are learning about ourselves. So relationship with others teach us a great deal about ourselves, and that's how we become one. Now, the thing to guard against with this combination in Pisces is to have your head in the clouds and not to be more in a place of illusion. So it's a very idealistic sign, Pisces, and combined with Jupiter's abundance and positivities, your expectations could go like really like beyond reality, beyond common sense. And so in order not to do that and set yourself up for disappointment, you want to rein that in and always stay connected with that intuitive sense of, does it feel right to expand to this extent? So some of the things that could be manifested in general over this time is, for everyone, a new spiritual understanding also other people unconsciously, their unconscious drivers, what is driving them to this point, what in their belief system has brought them to this point, and being compassionate about how you deal with that, respond to it. Remember, Jupiter also governs beliefs, Sagittarius, and we've talked a lot about beliefs in the last few podcasts. So this is a time to really extend compassion towards any belief or people who believe something because it has been indoctrinated by an external force. And then they have to come to terms with how their beliefs are showing up for them in terms of results, right? So there's a growing interest in spiritual understanding, in what religion means, spirituality in general. There's a fascination with mysticism, with anything to do with self-understanding through the stars, through the codes, through frequency, through healing. There can be new research into emotional, mental, spiritual health. There can be shakeups in the creative industries, music, entertainment, photography, film. There can be like a real sense of just realizing how important those industries are and how using them for everybody's highest good as opposed to using them to manipulate or take control is very important. So these things will come into the fore, and there'll be a greater acceptance of alternative healing. Pisces is opposite Virgo. They're connected. The opposite signs are always connected, and Virgo is the sign of healing. And so we have this sense of the watery, beautiful, like being near water, having water sounds, having a indoor fountain, or going to waterfalls, going to the ocean, going to the lakes, going to rivers, going to creeks, and just immersing yourself in that fountain of wisdom that comes through water. Also, innovations regarding marine life and the state of our oceans. And since Pisces is a water sign, Jupiter can bring expansion and abundance in a really, really big way, because it just grows and grows and grows. So that can also mean increased rainfall, increased flooding, increased water-themed events, anything water-themed, and increased healing. So unconditional love is really the basis of the Pisces experience, and that would mean to really let go of wanting to change others when we are in relationships, and that's really where we learn and experience love and being loved and being loving. The first thing we have to do is want to change the person who we're with. And so love is more important than any conditioned belief, any conditioned idea of how things should be. But if you take your conditioning more seriously than love, you lose love. So this is really a big key moment in general about how seriously do you take your beliefs, and do the beliefs actually take precedence over love? Basically, the other person or people are going to withhold love from you because it's too painful for him or her to love you if they are only aligned with their beliefs. To align yourself with love, with spirit, with the divine, and experience love and the other qualities of joy, Jupiter, and peace, Pisces, all you have to do is notice when love is present. And when you notice love and you acknowledge love, you are in a sense choosing love over the ego's ideas and beliefs. And that choice automatically brings you into alignment with the divine. So pay attention to when you notice love. The most minute moments here is what we're talking about. And, you know, the love that's expressed in nature. This divine essence lives for love. Everything within you that is natural lives for love. And it's not dissuaded by any judgments or any differences or any separation, any beliefs, because Source loves because it sees similarities, not differences. It sees how others are like yourself and are on their own journey. And so from the divine, you can experience this oneness, this compassion, this unity with everyone from the sacred place, which is love. And then it becomes easy to love, because love flows when we recognize our own divine self in other people, right? So it flows when we're able to see beyond the mind, or behind the egoic mask of the true self, which then becomes beautifully lovable and then evokes love when we can see beyond that, right? So all the qualities we love in others are qualities of the divine self. They are compassion, they are understanding, kindness, caring, patience, inner strength, courage. They're not qualities of the ego, which is self-centered and only is focused on its own needs. You can't be compassionate, wise, and loving when all your goals are focused on what's right for me, what's good for me, and never consider what's good for the greater whole, what is for everyone's greater good. So notice when you're identified with the ego, you don't feel very lovable yourself. But the essence that flows from the divine, from that Piscean, we are all one, from this beautiful essence, even makes the ego lovable, right? So nothing is not lovable in that state, because the ego doesn't know how to love, but the divine in us knows always how to love. And when this joyful divine quality in us acts and speaks in a kind, compassionate, sensitive way, we truly can connect at a level where everything that flows from us doesn't come from the ego. And that love then is the healing balm for everything. Instead of saying, what's in it for me, which always lingers in the background of every interaction that is egoic. And that's not love. It's manipulation disguised as love or kindness. And maybe it's better than undisguised manipulation, you know, in your face manipulation that's not hidden, but it's still not love in the purest sense. Pure love can only come from your true nature. It's that beautiful essence that is pure, and it's unadulterated goodness and kindness. So this is the quality that loves because it feels good to love. And there's no other reason. There's no ulterior motive, right? Which is manipulation. So why does it feel so good to be loving? Jupiter in Pisces wants us to immerse ourselves in the loving energy. So why does it feel so good? Because it is our natural design. It's the divine nature to love, since it's God's nature to love. The ego is the part of ourselves that has difficulty loving because loving makes it feel vulnerable. And loving someone gives that other person that we're loving power. That's something to notice, right? The ego wants to be the one in control and power, so it's hard for the ego to love. If we love someone, that person presumably has the power to then at some point hurt us or disappoint us. And the ego doesn't want to relinquish that power. And yet the ego does have a need, an underlying need, because we naturally are made from love. The ego has an underlying need to be loved, so it is vulnerable. And this love sense, this stretching, this Jupiter expansion in Pisces, love stretches the ego. Without that need for love, the ego could just comfortably be separate. It would be comfortable. It wouldn't ever reach out to others or act differently than it does. But because the ego does need love underneath it all, it must learn to love. And that is ultimately what then leads to the ego's dissolving, right? So, and that's because ego and love cannot be in the same space. One must go. It's either one or the other. And since our nature is to be oneness, Pisces, we are one with everything that exists, but we have been programmed to feel separate rather than to feel our oneness. That original oneness with the divine was then differentiated into two, and then into three, and then into four and five, and so on, until it filled the universe with diversity and with uniqueness, individuality, right? So this oneness rejoices in that grand spread of diversity, Jupiter in Pisces, because it provides a means for exploring and interacting with itself in limitless ways, which were not possible when there was just oneness without the division. So, of course, that separation from oneness is painful because it is maintained by the egoic mind that doesn't love. So we're separate not only from experiencing oneness, but also separate from experiencing love, right? Because of the division, except for those moments, those special moments when we do feel love, right? But the true love from our own nature is always there. It's always in the background. It trickles through the sense of separation and always is guiding us and always beckoning us back into our natural state. So here's the thing. Eventually, we all return to this oneness, this state that we came from. And we now come to this incredible return with an amazing gift. And Jupiter is the bringer of gifts, of fortune. And that gift is that we now have the awareness and appreciation of our individuality and uniqueness while being one with all. And that is really the return that is happening now. So we bring what we've learned through the experience of separation back to the oneness that we are. And that is the gift. That is the journey. So we return to oneness wiser for having been the creators of this reality and coming to an understanding of how it all, in the end, brings us back. So the adventure is complete. So love is what breaks that spell of the egoic separate state of consciousness. And love releases us from that prison of separation where we don't feel one with others for whatever belief or reason. It's love from others, from our relationships, that ultimately frees us, because we then become one with them. We then become vulnerable and we have opportunities, manifold opportunities to explore what it means to love or not to love. And Jupiter in Pisces then brings us home through the joyful expression of who we are. So we're coming home to love through joy. And feeling the joy while we experience life with others, always coming home to that joy, whether it is through humor or just pure allowing a joyful perspective to imbue whatever situation you're in, no matter what situation you're in, to be present with love and with caring and compassion and kindness. So this is really the message: to come back home, return to oneness, with that wisdom of having learned about the experience of separation and trusting in your true origins, that God is love. And another way to find out about your actual soul, your purpose for being here right now, is through your code. You have a star code as well, just like I talk about the star codes. We all have a personal star code. And to explore your own star code, I have a free masterclass for you at starcodeclass.com. So head on over there and you'll see how you can discover your life purpose, your destiny, look at the birth certificate name, what it means, your birthday, the degree numbers in your astrology chart, so much more. This is a wonderful opportunity to immerse yourself in the mystical, right? The truth of frequency. So enjoy that at starcodeclass.com and have a beautiful week and a beautiful movement into the Mercury retrograde Sagittarius total solar eclipse coming up on the 26th of May. And I will see you next week for our next Star Codes podcast. Lots of love.